Hi, once again a very warm welcome. Has it ever happened with you that you are handling someone who is too difficult? Maybe a colleague at work, or maybe your immediate superior at work, or maybe it's a family member who is very difficult to handle and you don't know what to do. Apart from being difficult persons, yet another thing why you are having so much problem in having this particular problem is that this person is unavoidable. Maybe you work directly with them and daily you have to see them at office. Daily you have to work with them. Daily you have to handle deadlines and balance everything. Or maybe it's a family member whom you cannot avoid. And you don't know what to do because the more you try to confront them, the more defensive they become. Now in this case, what do we do? Many people, when they come for one-on-one consulting with us, they say that this person is, you know, giving me so much anxiety, is causing me so much stress, and I can't even avoid that person, and I can't handle that person. And moreover, what happens is, when I try to talk to this person and try to resolve it, they absolutely do not agree with me, they do not even try to understand, and it's becoming day by day really very difficult to handle this person. What would you suggest? And also, I'm getting drained because I'm full day I'm talking with this person. I'm always trying to prove myself. And what do I do? Now, the situation could be anything, right? From having a very difficult person who is manipulating you, causing problems, giving you very difficult time. It could be something as bad as that, or it could be something like just having minor problems with that person, but which causes you to emotionally feel depleted. Now, what do we do in this case? And, you know, there are several techniques in which you learn how to handle people by studying and understanding how do you handle it. But today I'm going to share a very simple technique, which is also a spiritual technique and which actually works with the power of your subconscious mind. Now, if you know, your subconscious mind is very powerful and your subconscious mind can create anything you want. In fact, when you're trying to solve problems consciously, which means you are practically doing everything possible to solve a problem, but yet you are not able to solve it. Know that the answer is not in your conscious or in your practical mind. It is in the subconscious mind. And to actually work on that, you might need different techniques. Now, there are so many techniques which we discuss in coaching, which talk about how to handle subconscious mind. There are hypnotic scripts. There are guided meditations. There are cognitive activities. There are verbal clearings. And there is so much and so much which you can do. In fact, I would suggest all of you to read the book, The Power of Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy, because this book will actually talk about how the whole subconscious mind scenario works. But before that, if the problem is being really, really difficult to you, what can we do now? This is a technique which I call as letter writing to the higher power. Now, what is higher power? Higher power could be God, angels, divine, universe, by whatever force you call it. It could be that invisible force which we know is bigger than us. And when we ask for support from that bigger force, we can really get what we are looking for. Now, please note that this is not just a technique which I've read somewhere and I'm sharing with you. I myself have used this technique for the last almost 4 years, and I have seen tremendous improvement in my life with difficult people. And this technique has not just given me a way to vent out or to share things, but has also given me a new way to find mending the tension between me and other persons. Now, these persons could be people at work, it could be people in your family, extended family, friends, colleagues, practically anyone and everyone. So what do we do? So for this, we need a paper and a pen. Any basic paper pen, any notebook would do. There is no, many people come write to me saying that, should I get a ruled notebook or should it be a plain notebook? I think these things are irrelevant. You know, we've been living in this culture which has so much of rules and regulations, and where we've been told that if we do something little wrong, something bad will happen to us. So first, I want you to remove this thing from your mind. When you use these techniques, allow yourself to make mistakes. You're human. Even if you do something, even if it is a little bit wrong, nothing bad is going to happen to you. you're not going to die, you're not going to get cursed, or you're not going to get any negative energies. The only thing that will make things bad for you will be if you are doing something with a bad intention, to show someone down, to pull someone down, or to sabotage someone's life. If you're doing anything with evil intentions, please know that this procedure, this prayer is not for you, because this procedure and prayer will only work for the highest good of all. So take any paper pen, and on the top of the paper, I want you to write that I now invoke my higher self, and I also invoke my spiritual team. Okay, you can just simply write, I invoke the presence of my higher self and of my spiritual team. Now, spiritual team could be anyone and anyone and everyone you connect to. For a lot of people, they have a particular form of deity with whom they connect. For example, for someone, it could be Krishna, it could be Ganesh, it could be Jesus Christ, or it could be Buddha, or it all depends on your faith. There are no right or wrong answers here. And with whomsoever you connect, that is the right person, that is the right energy. I would not say person, that is the right energy to connect to. So you can say, I simply invoke the presence of my higher self, my spiritual team. Then you can mention whoever it is. Maybe it is Krishna, maybe it is Shiv Parvati, maybe it's Archangel Michael, Archangel Raphael, or any divine beings with whom you connect. You can also use the word universe, God, divine, alternatively. Once you write that, I want you to take a candle and light it. Now you would say, what kind of candles can I use? Any candle works. There are no rights and wrongs. Now you would say, I don't have a candle. What can I use? You can simply use a earthen lamp, a brass or metal lamp, the diya which we typically use in our Indian households. You can even light that. Now, why do we light that? We light that because that helps us to call upon the presence of the divine. Light is the indicator of removal of all negativity. So you can just light that candle or diya, close your eyes and just deep breathe and understand what is it that you want to achieve with this prayer. Perhaps it's someone at work who is really being mean to you, and you feel, you know, many times we go in the victim zone, which means we feel, oh, that person is doing bad to me, that person is so mean. But what if this is just an opportunity for you to learn, to understand that there are parts of us which need healing? So at that point of time, you can simply think of that person and just feel that, you know, I really want to improve this relationship. Now, when you simply say that, you have to have your highest interest in mind. You also need to have the highest interest of the other person, because once I was working with someone, and when we were working, we were doing coaching, and that person said that, you know, she had some problems with her one of the in-laws, and she said that, okay, so now can I write that this person should really suffer and all that, and whatever she's done to me will come back to her. And I said, no, that's not what we are looking for here. As I mentioned, if you have bad intentions for anyone, it's not going to work. So all that you want to look for is, you want to look for peace, you want to look for closure, you want to look for healing. So you can simply think of that person. Now you just think of that person, and you can simply say, now you can start writing a letter to their higher self. Now, what is their higher self? Their higher self is a powerful way of connecting to the God within them. So when we say namaste, it is all about the God in me greets the God in you, because we all are God's children. We are the manifestation of the force which has created us. So you are just greeting their God self, and we are doing this communication not with them, but with the God within them. So you can simply start writing, dear higher self of, you can write the name of that person. Now, please note that even if you're doing this for family, for friends, for, don't write my best friend or my mother-in-law or my mother or my husband or my wife or my girlfriend. Don't use those words. Write their full name, because that is the energetic vibration which is to which you're writing to. So for example, if I'm writing it to Ashwini Chubey, I'm just giving you an example because it's my name. So I can, you know, if someone has a problem with me and if they wish to mend it, they can simply write, dear higher self of Ashwini Chubey. if I'm writing to higher self of, say, Mr. XYZ, I can say, dear higher self of Mr. XYZ. Now, you are going to write their full name. Please be very careful here. Write their full name. Do not write, dear higher self of my mother or my mother-in-law or my husband. No, you're not going to do that. Next, you can also write, and the guardian angels slash spiritual team of, and then write their full name. Now, why are we doing that? We are invoking all the divine figures who are connected with that person. Now, you simply write this down. Now, here, after just writing their name, I want you to just sit for 2 minutes and pray to divine. And you can simply say, I now step back and now I allow the divine to write through me. Now, what is happening here is you are doing this prayer from your higher self to the higher self of this person. Okay. So it is not coming from ego. It is not coming from lower self. It is not coming from fear. It's not coming from anger. It's not coming from jealousy. It's not coming from, oh, you've been mean to me and I'm going to give it back to you. No, it's not coming from there. Instead, it is coming from a place where you are not allowing your lower self to operate here. So you simply say that I now step back and I now ask my higher self to write through me. As you say that, for the next 15 minutes, maybe you can put a timer for 15 minutes and pour your heart out. Now, this is a very important step. Pour your heart out. You can even write things like, dear so-and-so, you behaved this way with me. I did not like it. I felt cheated. I felt betrayed. I felt that I was not good enough, or I felt that you were trying to shoot me down. And I felt really very bad about that. And I know it is difficult right now between us, but I really wish to solve these things. I really wish to heal these differences, what we have with each other. After you write that down, I want you to imagine that person sitting in front of you. At this point of time, you could do a Ho'oponopono prayer, which means you can simply say, I'm sorry, please forgive me. I thank you. I love you. I've made a separate video on Ho'oponopono prayer. You can go back there. The link to that video will be in the description of this video. So you could simply do a Ho'oponopono prayer about 4-5 times till the time you feel peace. Next, you know, now Ho'oponopono, you're going to say, this is the letter which you have written. Towards the end of the letter, after doing the Ho'oponopono, just simply take your paper pen back and say that I would now like to make peace between both of us. Okay. You can also say that, please understand that if I've done anything unknowingly, which has hurt you, that was not the intention. And I wish to, I really feel that the differences between us should be mended. Now, if there are more than one instance, if this person has hurt you, you don't need to write each and everything. Okay. You can just write something which has triggered you a lot, but you can keep on asking for love, peace, and forgiveness. And you can also say that, you know, I ask for forgiveness from you and I forgive you. Now, to many people, this will be really difficult. They might even say that I will not forgive that person because they've been really bad to me. So, well, if you are one of those persons who are watching this video and saying that I really don't want to forgive that person, all I can say is it's a choice, because forgiveness is a choice. Healing relationship between you and someone else is a choice. Also, being in peace is a choice. So if you do not choose this, if you're not choosing it, probably you're not even going to watch the video till here. But if you are right now even not wanting to forgive that person, you know, it's probably you can stop watching this video and not do this ritual again, because come back to this video when you're ready. Now, again, forgiveness doesn't mean that I'm someone great, I'm God, and you are not, and I forgive you because you've been bad to me, but I'm good. That's not what is forgiveness. Forgiveness is knowing that this person has done ill to you because there is a reason, because there is something which has happened. Now, it's totally up to you whether you want to break relationships with that person totally and not be in contact with them. Forgiveness doesn't mean go back to them and start talking again. Now, you know, sometimes people say that the person is no longer in my life, but should I go back and talk to them? Well, if you feel like, please go, but don't force yourself. You know, I always tell you that your heart is the biggest map in your journey of life. Do what your heart feels. Please stop paying attention to all those people who kept telling you that don't listen to your heart. It is a sign of weakness, because if you listen to your heart, if you don't listen to your heart, it causes heart pressure. It causes, emotional bottling of emotions. It is a lot of what we call as pressure on your heart chakra, and which is not good for you, not just your emotional and mental self. It can later on in your life cause even physical problems. So do not do anything which your heart doesn't guide you. But if your heart gives you some guidance, do it. Now, the next thing after you can end a letter saying that thank you for understanding and thank you for allowing this thing to get solved. Let there be peace between us. Now, when you say that, really mean it. I also want you to visualize that there is peace between you and this person, and you are either in a good relation or you are not talking to each other, but you still have no grudges with them. And you can end this letter by saying thank you, and you can write your name. After you're done that, keep the letter in front of the candle, and I want you to sit in that space for say another good 15-20 minutes. Just be there. Optionally, okay, you can, for the next 3 days, you can read this letter loudly by lighting a candle. So now, once you're done with this, you can extinguish the candle. Never blow it with your mouth. Just extinguish it and just allow this energy to mend. Just give it to the universe. Alternatively, what you can also do is, now, for example, you did the letter writing on day one. On day two, day three, and day four, you can again light the same candle. Okay. And read the letter loudly. Okay. And visualize that all the problems between you and this person have been solved. On 2, 3, and 4, do it. After reading the letter, extinguish the candle. On the fourth day, allow the candle to completely burn down. And take the letter. Okay. And you can simply tear it and either put it in your garden with your trees or anywhere in soil, which means you're giving it to the universe. Okay, now, again, there are no hard and fast rules, so don't come back to me with questions like, oh, now, I've not torn the letter, can I just put it in the garden? Yes. I don't know what to do. The candle got extinguished in, okay, so if the candle gets extinguished in between, it's not a bad omen or anything. You can use another candle, and you can either use the same candle for all 4 days and let it burn down on the last day, or you can use separate 4 candles on separate 4 days, totally what suits you. Okay. Another important point about this ritual is, it's very important to, along with this ritual for the next 4 days, if you can keep listening to the Ho'oponopono chant, it will really help you. The easiest way to access the Ho'oponopono chant is you can listen to any Ho'oponopono chants on YouTube. For me, before I go to sleep, the last 15 minutes before I sleep, I play Ho'oponopono loudly, and I sleep listening to that. That's most of the days what I end my day with, and I release everything that doesn't serve me. So if you feel that is good, you can do that as well. That will really help you release a lot of judgments. And I would love to hear, how does this procedure go? What miracles do you all see? Now, this is the basic, simple, most prayer which you can do, and I'm sure it can be really very, very helpful. Now, additionally, this is the easiest and the safest method to do the prayer. Now, additionally, when you do this prayer, you can also use crystals. For example, you can use crystals like rose quartz. Rose quartz is very good to help you open your heart and to build that love consciousness with you and the person concerned. If you are having any problems with people who are being really manipulative and all that, you can also use the black tourmaline. So what to do is, when you write it on the paper, and when you keep the paper in front of the candle, put these two crystals on them. Also, you can put maybe you can put the paper with the crystals, and you can keep it in a safe place, especially if you don't have the privacy in your home and you don't want other people in your house to see it. So you can just keep it there. So you can use additional crystals. You can also use essential oils. The best way is before writing the paper, before writing the letter, you can put a few drops of lavender and rose essential oil on the paper. So the paper is already having the energies of the essential oil, which means you're already invoking the higher energies. You can also, you know, you can also invoke the presence of angels. Now, I always do this. So when I do this particular letter writing, I invoke the presence of Archangels Michael, Raphael, Uriel, and Gabriel from the four directions. Okay. And I also invoke the presence of Archangel Raguel, R-A-G-U-E-L, who is the angel of healing conflicts and creating peace and joy and love and all of love and order. This is a very powerful angel. You can also invoke the presence of Master Murli for magic. One more thing. Now, these are different things you can add. These are additional things. These are not necessary. So if you say, I don't have crystals or I don't want to do the angel prayer, it's still okay. These are additional things which will make your angel prayer even more beautiful. Another thing what you could do is you could play some beautiful chants in the background when you're doing this ritual, which adds that aroma to this. So, you know, when I'm doing my meditations, my rituals, I'm usually playing some nice chants in the room. I'm either playing Om Namah Shivaya, or I'm playing chants of Lord Krishna, or I'm playing chants of Archangel Michael. They really help me uplift my energy, and they help me be in a very good energy. You can also play Ho'oponopono in the background. That is very easy and very safe. And feel free to light candles, put many crystals. If you have Himalayan salt lamps, do that. If you have more plants in your room, flowers in your room, that will add that. So these are the things which keep vibrations higher. Another thing what you could do is when you're doing this ritual, take a small bowl of rock salt or any salt and place it on the paper. And when you keep the paper, keep the salt with the paper. All the 3 days when you read it, take the bowl of salt and crystal along with it. On the fourth day, without touching the salt, flush the salt in the toilet. Flush it completely and dispose the paper, wash the crystals, let the candle burn down and throw away the candle, the remaining parts of the candle. And you can bury your letter somewhere in your garden, or if you don't have a garden close by, you can even burn it. Or even I tell people sometimes, if you don't know where to throw it, you can even tear it and throw it in the dustbin. It's still okay. You're giving it to the universe. You've released it. So I have found a lot of relief. I have found a lot of relationships improving. So 3 things might happen. First, the relationship between you and that person changes so well that you either become best friends or, you know, you get along very well and you have a very peaceful life. Second, that person totally goes out of your life, which means, you know, I've seen people leaving the organization. If you have a difficult colleague, they leave the organization, move to another department, move to another place, or maybe they are not in your team anymore. And the third thing which could happen is that person's nature slowly starts getting a little better, and also it stops triggering you. Okay, now know that this problem which you have between you and that person is not just their problem. So stop pointing fingers at that person. Know that first take ownership of this healing and know that it's, you know, as we say in Hindi, Tali dono haathon se bajti hai. We clap with both the hands. So you are not going to blame any one person for that. There is a healing from your part which is also needed. So please know that. And I hope this technique helps you. It has personally helped me a lot with so many people, with so many relations. And that's the reason I'm sharing this with you. It's tried and tested. I'm doing this technique since 2018 and I've really been really benefited by it. So please write to me. Please comment on the video below if this technique helps you, or if after watching this video, you feel some kind of shift. Also, you could write to me on ashwini.chubey@unicorninsights.com. Also to book a one-on-one coaching, a tarot or an angel card reading, a healing session with me, you can write to me on my email ID, ashwini.chubey@unicorninsight.com. I would meet you only on appointments. And if you really wish to create that transformation in your life, do not hesitate to get back to me for one-on-one coaching. So this is a very beautiful, quick technique from me. You can subscribe to our channel to have such more videos, upcoming ones. And if this video is something which has really benefited you, please share it with all your friends and family, like and subscribe. To know more about our work, log on to www.unicorninsight.com. Thank you.